Within vectors, it's also important to look at what's not necessarily a vector. So we haven't learned this yet, but there's something else called a scalar. And I want to define that, actually. A scalar is something, well, actually, we'll define it maybe as something different from a vector. Remember that a vector has direction and magnitude, just like that really awesome poem, right, that I showed you. This poem right here. Roses are red, violets are blue, vectors have direction and magnitude too. So they're arrows. So because of that, we can take a look at this. So vectors have direction and magnitude. In other words, they have a length, and they also need to have a direction. Direction matters when you talk about vectors. But scalars are things with just magnitude. In other words, they only have a length. In other words, direction doesn't matter. So it's a quantity that you measure that it's silly to say a direction. A direction will be stupid to talk about. So there's a whole bunch of different examples that we can do. So let's say for scalars, these are things with only a magnitude, only a length. So there's something that we could measure. We call it distance. Now, it all depends on what textbooks and things like that you use, but distance is often written as the letter S for some reason, instead of D. It's just written as an S. And it's often measured in meters. So I'm going to put that in brackets here, what symbol we use to denote it, and its unit. So this is in meters. We have something else called speed. Now this one is the one hopefully you know. It's V. And that's measured in meters per second. And we often write it with a meters times seconds to the minus one, but you can also say meters per second. It's the same thing. Same. So these are things where it doesn't make sense to say, like, you know, how far have I walked? Well, I've walked 5 meters. It doesn't mean anything to say the direction that I've gone. Not if I'm talking about distance or speed. And turns out there's other quantities. There's things like time. Time. We use T to mean time, and we often measure it in seconds. And hopefully it makes sense. We wouldn't say, what time is it? It's 3 o'clock right. That doesn't make any sense. Or it's 2 o'clock north. No, so we don't put a direction, so that's why it's a scalar. We have all sorts of other quantities that we use. I mean, I'm a physicist, so you can see the examples that I use are often physics-y ones, but there's lots of examples in everyday life of these scalars. So mass is something we use. We often measure it with the letter M, and we measure it in units of kilograms. So we can say my mass is, you know, 80 kilograms or something, or 70 kilograms. We have lots of other things like energy. We often use capital E for that, and that's measured in joules. Lots of quantities. There's lots more. I could do dot, 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 tons more. I could do a giant list. But I don't want to bore you to death here. I just want to give you some examples. So those are examples of scalars. Now over here we have vectors. And I'm going to write, and it turns out distance has a vector version, and it's called displacement. That one is different. Now watch very carefully. When we write vectors, they're often written with a capital. They're not written with a capital. They're written with a bold-faced letter. So in other words, instead of distance S, they would distance S like this. They would write displacement as S, but really, really dark in a textbook, or really bold. Now that's going to look really stupid if I keep trying to do this. So another convention, because I'm not very good at drawing bold-faced letters. Another convention is to draw a little arrow on top. Remember, vectors are arrows. So instead of that, I'm going to use the same symbol, except I'm just going to chuck a little arrow on top. And we get tired of drawing both ends of the arrow, so we often write an arrow with just the top end. That's the short form that I've been using for years. That's what I've been taught, and I may as well teach it to you. Displacement S. Just like we have speed. We have a vector version of speed, and it's called velocity. So if we talk about velocity, that means we need to state it with this little symbol, V with a little vector symbol. This tells us this quantity is a vector. This quantity is a vector. Remember, this is still measured in the same unit, so this is still in meters. This is still meters per second, for example. And maybe it helps to give you an example. So here I'll say, I don't know, the displacement is 2 meters, let's say, north. There we go. So this would tell me, how far am I from my start point? Oh, I'm 2 meters to the north of my start point. In other words, displacement, a direction matters. You need a direction here. Just like if you have a velocity, maybe I can say my velocity, maybe I fly off a cliff. So maybe my velocity is, 5 meters per second Maybe it's downwards. You know, if I'm just about to hit the ground, for example, my velocity is important that it's downwards. I'm not flying up, I'm going downwards. So direction here matters. There's lots of other quantities that are vectors. There's something else called acceleration. And thankfully, we use a letter that makes sense for that. We use A. And that's in meters per second squared. In other words, it's meters per second per second. So I might say my acceleration then is 9.81 meters per second squared, downwards as well in this case. I could use whatever I wanted, right? I could have a force. Force, we often use F to denote a force. That's measured in things called newtons. This is not north here. This is a unit of force. It's called a newton. It's otherwise known as a kilogram meter per second squared. But I think it's nice just to use the proper unit here. It's called a newton. So I can say, oh, I don't know, my force then. Oops, I should put a little vector symbol on top of it. Force, I don't know, maybe it's 15 newtons. And maybe this is some sort of, I don't know, dinosaur that's pulling me. So maybe this is a force that's heading east or something. So vectors are quantities that where direction matters. It's absolutely important. You have to state or think about not only the length of the arrow, but also the direction that the arrow is pointing. Those are vectors. And opposite to those are scalars. Scalars only have a magnitude, in other words, only a length, only a value. But the direction doesn't matter. Direction is silly here. It doesn't make sense.